This video is going to be about converse, inverse, and contrapositive statements. So let's start with two simple statements. Statement P, I am in Paris, and statement Q, I am in France. Now we can combine both of these into a single conditional statement. If P, then Q. Or I could read that as, if I am in Paris, then I am in France. We could also take this conditional statement and rearrange the letters. I could turn this into if Q, then P. This is called a converse of the original statement. Converse. And I would read this as if I am in France, then I am in Paris. Now, obviously, this is not necessarily true. There's a lot of places I could be in France without being in Paris. Another way I could rearrange that original conditional statement would be to negate both sides. I could say, if I'm not in Paris, then I'm not in France. If not P, then not Q. This is called an inverse, and it's also not necessarily true. If I'm not in Paris, it doesn't mean I'm not in France at all. There's other places I could be. So for both the converse and the inverse, it's not necessarily true that they are true. It's not necessarily the fact that they're true, just because the original conditional statement was true. Now there's another way I could combine them. I could both rearrange the letters and I could negate them. So I could say, if not Q, then not P. This is called a contrapositive. Contrapositive. And reading this with the original statements, I would say, if I am not in France, then I am not in Paris. And that makes sense. So if the original conditional made sense, if the original conditional was true, if I am in Paris, then I am in France, then the contrapositive is also true. What I want to do is take a second and just fill in a truth table with both the conditional and its contrapositive. So I've got this started already. I've rewritten the original two sentences, two statements. I am in Paris for P, and Q, I am in France. And I filled in columns for P and Q and the conditional. And remember, when you have a conditional, the only place the conditional is not true, the only place where it's false, is when you have a true statement and then a false statement. So let's see what happens with the contrapositive. Well, first we have to fill in not Q. So not Q is going to be the opposite of the Q column, since the Q column was true, false. For not Q, I want false, true, false, true. For the not P column, I just go over to the P column and reverse those letters also. So instead of true, true, false, false, I'm going to have false, false, true, and true. And now I want to fill in the contrapositive column. If not Q, then not P. Well, you realize, since I've got an if and then, this is also a conditional statement. The only place this conditional statement is going to be false is when I start out with a true and follow that with a false. So when not Q is true and not P is false, this contrapositive is going to be false. When both not Q and not P are false, the contrapositive is true. When not Q is false and not P is true, the contrapositive is true. And when they're both true, the contrapositive is true. Now, if I compare the columns for the original conditional, if P then Q, and the contrapositive, if not Q then not P, I see I have exactly the same truth values in the same order. I have true for both of them, then false, then true, then true, which means that both a conditional and its contrapositive are logically equivalent. You remember we write the logically equivalent sign by writing, I'm going to write if P, then Q, and then put in the equivalent sign, the three bars, like an equal sign but with an extra bar, and then the contrapositive. If not Q, then not P. Okay? So basically, you've got your original conditional statement, if P, then Q. You've got the contrapositive that was made from it, if not Q, then not P. And looking at the truth tables for them, we realize that they are logical equivalents of each other. Okay, that's it for now. Take care, and I'll see you next time.